Let's cross to Johannesburg now, because in the studio in Joburg, the Power Lunch studio, is Keith Levenstein, the CEO of Econo BEE. And I just got this across the Power Lunch desk here, and it says the following. The recently gazetted ICT charter appears to be a step backwards. And some quite strong words from Keith now, and I'll just read you a couple of sentences from this press release that he's kindly sent us. In the case of the newly released ICT charter sector code, he says, we believe it has taken a huge step backwards. The ICT codes are riddled with spelling mistakes and grammatical errors, unforgivable, and I agree with him on this one. They perpetuate many errors in the codes, etc., etc. And Keith Levenstein is in the Joburg studio, as I said. Keith, how serious a problem is this? I mean, apart from the grammatical errors, what about the content?
I mean, Lindsay, my big complaint with regard to any of the charters is quite simply that they're not that terribly difficult from the normal codes of good practice. It's taken the ICT charter Charter Council around about 7 years in order to, reach this particular stage. During that time, there's been a lot of confusion. Many IT companies are completely unaware of what they need to do, and there's been lots of confusion. The content of the charter is not terribly bad, other than it isn't that consistent with the rest of the codes of good practice, and that's maybe a bigger concern than simply the spelling mistakes that adds to the confusion in the first place.
Yeah, and the unprofessional nature of the whole thing. I mean, you say that we cannot accept that the ICT charter issued more than 5 years after the code still has these problems. This is not purely an academic exercise. It has huge ramifications. What ramifications are you referring to, Keith?
Lindsay, the ramification, quite simply, is a company without a B certificate is going to potentially lose a lot of business. They can lose a lot of tender business from government. They can lose business from their own clients. So if they don't have a B scorecard, or if it isn't very clear, they can certainly get a lower B score than some other company, an opposition company, who might have a different interpretation. Now, as we tend to say, and I had a ICT sector council or sector code presentation this morning, BEE isn't about a piece of paper that looks good. It's something that's really serious, and transformation is incredibly serious. But at the same time, companies live and or die. Their businesses will simply grow if they have a good scorecard or not. So we're not talking about just that piece of paper that makes no difference, those numbers on it. And the numbers are really important. Those numbers need to mean something, which unfortunately in many cases they don't mean enough.
Exactly. It's not just about ticking a box and saying I've got this and I've got that. I suppose if you're required to transform, and of course you should transform, there needs to be a bureaucratic infrastructure in place that is clear. And what you're saying is that clearly it's not clear.
It's very, very unclear. Regretfully so. I tried almost without any success yesterday to contact the ICT Sector Council that should have been established with the launch of the ICT codes. When I did get hold of somebody at the Department of Communication, all they could tell me is they would come back to me with a couple of questions. And my question was a fairly simple question, but quite pertinent, I think. The question was, if you are in the ICT industry and you're being verified today, which scorecard do you follow? And the codes are quite clear. You have to use the ICT sector code right as it stands. But companies haven't had the opportunity to adjust to the new sector code. They should have given me a better answer, and they really came back and said the man said he wasn't sure and he would come back to me, which so far he hasn't.
Wasn't sure is one thing, not coming back to you is another. It all sounds like a bit of a mess. I mean, in general, apart from all the problems that you've just highlighted, which are serious, serious problems, as you've said, with serious ramifications, how has the ICT sector conducted itself in terms of transformation over the years?
I think they've tended to do probably a better job than some of the other sectors. The sectors that haven't performed incredibly well might include, say, the manufacturing and engineering sector. But in the case of ICT, I think they can give themselves a pat on the back. You get companies who are included in the sector code, such as MTN, who have reached level 2, which is incredibly good. Dimension Data, I think, are level 2, level 3 at the moment. And many other companies have embraced transformation to a large extent. Obviously, they have to, because their own customers are calling them for their really good, decent B scorecard. So I think they've done a really good job. They didn't deserve to have a scorecard thrust on them of this nature. They are already doing a good job. There really wasn't a reason for them to change the rules from the codes of good practice. And when we look at it, after going through this whole 9 years of process, the huge amount of codes and documents, the end result is all these companies are going to probably reach the exact same level that they would have reached anyway without the ICT sector code. So why waste literally millions of rands worth of consultants, lawyers, company money to really not add any value to the transformation process, which is so dear to my heart?
Well, you mentioned two big companies there, two giant companies, Dimension Data, formerly listed on the JSE, now sadly not, MTN, communications giant. I mean, absolutely massive. And I can understand they've got squads of people, teams of people working on these things. And even if the infrastructure or the bureaucracy and the admin isn't exactly clear, they can wade their way through it. But what about the smaller and medium-sized companies who don't have those sort of resources? How are they coping?
At the end of the day, I think that many companies will realize that it's not incredibly difficult to become compliant. If you embrace BEE and you talk about it and see it as a process, it's something that gets in basically built into the particular company's culture in the first place. So there's no real difficulty for them to understand it and to implement it. After all, you know, just to mention, it's not difficult to implement socio-economic development, which is charity. It's not difficult to do enterprise development, which is such an important part of transformation in the first place. Things like procurement are easy to do, and even ownership and management, which are maybe the more controversial aspects, isn't that terribly difficult? So no, Lindsay, I think the companies are not finding too great a difficulty in becoming compliant. Yes, there are some who don't want to embrace the concept, but it's not that incredibly difficult. And of course, a smaller company that has a turnover of below 35 million is known as this qualifying small enterprise or QSE, and they find it really easy to become compliant. And I think that the ICT sector has done a pretty good job of transforming themselves.
Good. Keith, we'll have to leave it there, but thanks very much for your time this morning. And keep up the good work and keep lobbying these people and keep pestering them. And if that bloke doesn't come back to you, ring him up again. That's Keith Levenstein, who is the CEO of Econo BEE.